भवाप्ययौ हि भूतानां श्रुतौ विस्तरशो मया त्वत्तः कमलपत्राक्ष माहात्म्यमपि चाव्ययम्।
From you, O Kamalapatraksha, O lotus-eyed one, I have heard at length the origin and dissolution of beings, as well as your inexhaustible greatness. So he says, Kamalapatraksha, lotus-eyed one, means person who has an arresting personality, an impressive personality, a charisma, something about the presence of a person. And that is not, don't misunderstand it. Even though he says Kamala Patraksha, it has nothing to do with his looks, it has nothing to do with the eyes. It has something to do with the fact that Atman has been uncovered and Atman is shining forth. Such a person has what we call as the tejas, irresistible personality like Krishna's. You hear the stories of Krishna and that's enough right through the ages. That tremendous magnetic personality of his comes forth, so much so that even today, when you have so many serials on Krishna and Rama and all that, why do they have such attraction? Because it's about a person who has uncovered the self. That state is something that you and I are heir to. So all you have to do is what? Just remove the trash. Around that Atman, we are carrying so much trash. All you have to do is get rid of that trash. Even in the Dhyana Shlokas, he refers to Vyasa by saying, Pullaravindayata Patra Netra. Fantastic personality. What a fabulous, whose eyes are as beautiful as a lotus. So, then he says, the origin and dissolution of beings. When you look at the ocean and the waves on the surface of the ocean, you see something there, you see the wave. But that wave has a birth, has an existence and a death. So as long as you're viewing the wave from the point of view of the birth, existence and death, you really don't know what the wave is. Shift your attention from the wave to the ocean. Understand the ocean, then look back at the wave. What do you see? You see the wave, but you understand the ocean. And that understanding of the ocean is what protects you from the trauma of the birth, the existence, and the death. And so is it in our lives. We're looking at each other, we're looking at ourselves only as waves. We don't understand the ocean. So how do we actually implement it? When you identify yourself with a higher goal, a higher ideal, everyone within the periphery of that ideal then becomes you. You become one with that ideal. And that's how you keep expanding till the highest ideal is self-realization. And that's when you really understand who you are. Just as you understand a wave only when you understand the ocean. You understand yourself only when you understand Atman, the totality. And then he says, as well as your inexhaustible greatness, Mahatmyam, the glory of that totality. Brahman is that which supports the entire universe. Out of Brahman, this whole universe has come into being. Brahman is infinite. The universe is infinite. When this infinite universe has emerged out of that infinite Brahman, what remains is infinite. So you understand this Mahatmyam of Brahman. Brahman retains its infinite stature in spite of the fact that many, many universes have emerged from it.